Meanwhile, Japan has already felt 19 aftershocks. So we had somebody from the U.S. Geological Survey who said that they have had aftershocks,
look at that.
Smaller ones in the hundreds, and it continues to shake right now. We are joined on the phone by Josiah Cheatham. Am I saying that name right?
Yeah, yes, you are.
All right. Josiah is taking a semester off from college to live in Japan. He was an hour south of Tokyo when the quake hit. All right, Josiah, tell us what it felt like where you were.
Well, actually, I was in a department store on the third floor, and all I remember was I was actually in Ebina, and there's a train station near there, and all I remember was everything just started shaking, and I've never been in an earthquake before, so the first thing that goes through my mind was like, you know, maybe this is, you know, the train station or something with the train going on.
Right.
You know, it got worse and worse, and it was a pretty scary experience.
Right, and so that was the initial earthquake, and the aftershocks that came after, we have other people reporting, too. The aftershocks are pretty devastating.
Yeah, everything, as far as where I was pretty mild compared to, you know, up north and near Tokyo. But, yeah, the aftershocks, I remember, like, seeing this bridge just, you know, just shaking, you know, and, like, people, like, holding on to it just to stand up, and it was pretty crazy.
I can't imagine what you must be going through, knowing, are you there by yourself? I mean, obviously you don't have family there, right? You're taking a semester off, or do you?
Yeah, yeah. I have a few friends who are Japanese who live here.
Where are you from?
I'm actually from Oxford, Mississippi.
All right. We hear a lot about that on the Fox News Channel, particularly at 7 o'clock Eastern time. Hey, Josiah, when you went to Japan, you knew there was a possibility of an earthquake because they have a lot of them there. Were you prepared for something this big?
Well, not really. I've heard of, you know, that Japan has had earthquakes in the past. And, you know, I figured I might encounter, you know, something small, maybe a small tremor or something like that. But, you know, nothing as big a scale as this, you know, the strongest earthquake in Japan history.
So, and the tsunami. Are you watching these pictures on television?
Yeah, yeah. Like, as soon as I got home, like, I actually didn't realize how big this was until I actually got home and just turned the news on and just saw the waves coming in and, you know, just houses being swept and cars being swept off the streets. You know, it was shocking for me.
So you're able to watch a local coverage there, and Sendai seems to be the city in Japan that was hit the worst. I'm communicating via Twitter with people in Japan. Now they're telling me 1,100 people are stranded at the Sendai airport because the entire airport, as we've been showing pictures this morning, surrounded by the tsunami water. Can you shed any light on that, what you're hearing on local TV?
Well, as far as I really can't that, but what I can say, as far as being stranded, I actually have a few friends that I contacted right after the earthquake, and one of my friends, he was on a train heading to Shinjuku station, the biggest station in Japan, and the train actually stopped, like everything just like shut down, and they were actually stuck on the tracks for climb, and he even said they had to walk from the train to Shinjuku Station because apparently they're pretty close, and they had to wait there for buses to come pick them up to take them to their houses.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Josiah Cheatham, we thank you very much for joining us live. He's a kid from Mississippi who's doing a semester abroad in Japan, and he was to the south of Tokyo when it hit.